Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to fix when you can't add color to vector artwork in Adobe Illustrator. Or maybe you are adding a color and it's turning out gray or something like that. All right, let's get started. I'll go over the solution first if that's all you need, and then we'll jump into why this happens. So I'm here in Adobe Illustrator, and I'm just going to get on my selection tool, select the design, come up here to the color panel, and that is under window if you need it. Next, go to your hamburger menu, then select either RGB or CMYK. I'm gonna go with RGB. And now I can change the color. So let's say I just pick this yellow or green or blue. Any color will work now. Now, if you have more than one color in your design, right now I have two colors, black and white. You can see a little question mark here. So what you'll have to do is get on your group selection tool, that's this one right up here, click the color and then just do select, same, fill color. That'll select all the same color. Then just do the same process. Come up to your color panel and choose RGB. I'm going to do the same thing for my white. I'll just come up and choose RGB. And then we can change this to whatever color we want. I think I'm gonna go with kind of a tan here. And for the black, I will choose a brown. So if you have a lot of different colors, you're going to have to go through that process a few times. Now this is even more confusing in Illustrator 2024. Because initially, your design will show whatever color you chose, but once you hit OK, it'll revert to gray. But the process is the same. Just come up to Color, choose RGB or CMYK, then it'll show the color you changed it to. So what's happening here is I originally image traced this with the black and white setting. So when you have a raster design and you choose Image Trace up here, if you just click the image trace button instead of choosing a different preset, it'll automatically create your design in grayscale. Even though I haven't found a single designer yet who actually wants this to happen, I would say most of us want the default to be RGB, so we won't continually have to change the colors over here. So the two times that this could happen is using this image trace preset or when you download a vector that is already a grayscale. The default grayscale mode is applied because Illustrator assumes that if you're working with a black and white trace, you're focusing on tonal values instead of color. Maybe it's thinking that you're preparing artwork for monochrome printing or something like that. In the comments section, please let me know if you would prefer Illustrator to automatically have the default of image trace to set as RGB instead of grayscale, or let me know if you like it the way it is. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you did and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you next week with another video. Thank you.